Tonight's Good Sword is a man who's learnt that spare fruit can preserve the most important things in life.
Yes, Hayden Jones went to Kingston to meet David Giles, who spent years turning jam into cash for his community.
Kingston, population 200, is at the bottom of Lake Wakatipu. It's famous for its train and now its condiments.
Now, there's no letterboxes in Kingston, but David and Sheila said look for the one with the ambulance and the boat. I think I've found it.
We're here to see some jam being made.
Raspberries? Raspberry jam?
Sheila Giles is the reluctant cook.
I just kind of got roped in to help when his health got to the point where he couldn't, you know, do it anymore.
Her husband David used to be chief jam maker until the emphysema sent him to his armchair.
No, it's just frustrating, you know, not to be able to do the simple things.
Now, David's always made the jam.
Because I love marmalade, being British.
A few years ago, he decided to sell it with the money going to a local cause, and he learned he's a great jam maker and great seller. 350 jars in one day is his record.
One person called me a predator, and I took offence at that. Then I thought, well, no, I probably am.
I was chief pourer, because my hands were steadier than David's, so I'd pour and he'd put the lids on and put the labels on.
Now, David can sniff out spare fruit anywhere.
We go knock on the door and ask permission, unless they're a holiday home, and then we leave a note to say thank you. Hi, how are you?
David.
Where's me hug?
In the end, David and Sheila made so much jam, Kingston's fire station is three wide instead of two, the town's ambulance has a garage, the new mums have a place to meet Plunkett, and visiting doctors have a surgery to see their patients.
We were just bowled over the fact that $10,000 could come from a kitchen.
I go too fast, I can't walk fast.
David and Sheila made 10,000 jars of jam. That's $10,000 for their community. Then David got sick and Sheila got cancer, and Kingston got the chance to pay it back with meals and kindness.
I mean, if the love and support of a community is a cure for something, we'd be cured tenfold.
David Giles says the giving was easier than the receiving.
I'm part of the community, and therefore I've got to give to it. It's just where I am.
I don't think he realised he could give so much. Hayden Jones, One News.